One of the fields that we sort of ignored in our earlier discussion of calculated data was the conversion factor field. And in most cases, that will remain a 1. Let me take a few moments to explain what a conversion factor is. One of the unique features of the Pi system is that we don't have any unit of measure table. There's no way to track what unit of measure we are measuring something in. So if you have a flow rate and you're measuring flow of cubic feet per minute, and then you're measuring cubic feet for hours, those are going to be very different calculations. You're going to expect much larger numbers in the cubic feet per hour calculation. And so taking that into account, we need to specify in the total function, and remember this is only for totals. When you're doing a totalization, you need to tell the system what unit of measure you're using. Now, some people say, well, Pi does have an engineering units field in each tag. However, that field is a string tag. It's a freeform field. It doesn't have any more functionality than the description does. And so when Pi data link does a total function, and is when the Pi server does a total function, it assumes units per day. And that may or may not be correct. If it's not correct and you are measuring in something else, you need to use the conversion factor in order to get the correct number. And so, for example, if your valve or your flow meter were measuring in units per minute, gallons per minute or liters per minute, you would use a conversion factor of 1440. Remember, only with totalizations. Here's a quick example of that just illustrates the fact. If you had this flow, you could probably figure out what the total of this flow was given a paper and pencil in a few minutes to figure it out. We've got flow over here indicated on the left, and along the bottom we've got time in hours. And if we're looking at an 8-hour time frame, then for the first 3 hours we are producing product at a rate of 3 cubic meters per hour. If you multiply that out, that's going to give us 9 cubic meters. Over the next 2 hours, we produce product at 5 cubic meters per hour. That's another 10 cubic meters. And then over the last 3 hours, we produce 1 cubic meter per hour. That's 3 more. So if when you add it all up in a normal totalization, you get 22 cubic meters. However, because Pi assumes units per day, we multiply each of those calculations by something over 24. And so we get the result at the end, which is not quite correct. We have to multiply by 24 because our measuring unit of measure is something per hour. So we multiply by 24, and that gives us the correct amount. So when you're dealing with totalizations or totals, you need the conversion factor. Whenever you're dealing with any other calculation, the conversion factor should remain 1.